Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the entire Warhawk family of athletics, welcome to the 58th annual University of Wisconsin-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame Banquet. My name is Mark Moss, and I have the privilege of being your MC tonight for the evening's festivities. And now, let's meet our guests of honor. From Sussex, Wisconsin, Tim Patterson, accompanied by his wife, Leah Patterson. Tim is the recipient of the Distinguished Service Award. Tim Patterson. From Fort Atkinson, Wisconsin, Bob Lanza, accompanied by his wife, Linda Lanza. Bob was an athletic administrator from 1985 through 2017. Bob Lanza. Originally from Maquonago, Wisconsin, currently residing in Platteville, Wisconsin, Brent Allen, accompanied by his wife, Tiffany Allen. Brent was a member of the football team from 2003 through 2007. Brent Allen. Originally from South Milwaukee, Wisconsin, currently residing in Arvada, Colorado, Dan Heitnan. Accompanied by his wife, Alexandria Heitnan, Dan was a member of the track and field team from 2005 through 2008. Dan Heitnan. Originally from Williams Bay, Wisconsin, currently residing in Elkhorn, Wisconsin, Rebecca Nelson Johnson. Accompanied by her husband, Mike Johnson. Rebecca was a member of the volleyball team from 2004 through 2007. Rebecca Nelson Johnson. Originally from New Holstein, Wisconsin, and currently residing in New Holstein, Jessica Coleman. Accompanied by her father, Ken Coleman, Jessica was a member of the track and field team from 1998 through 2001. Jessica Coleman. Originally from Stoughton, Wisconsin, currently residing in Mount Horeb, Wisconsin, Kate Lazat Langfeld. Accompanied by her husband, Chuck Langfeld, Kate was a member of the volleyball team from 2004 through 2007. Kate Lazat Langfeld. Originally from Madison, Wisconsin, currently residing in Chicago, Illinois, Andre McCoy. Accompanied by Andra Gramer. Andre was a member of the basketball team from 1981 through 1984. Andre McCoy, originally from Verona, Wisconsin, currently residing in St. Louis, Missouri, Derek Stanley, accompanied by his son, Price Stanley. Derek was a member of the football team from 2003 through 2006, and the track and field team from 2004 through 2008. Derek Stanley. Originally from Oak Lawn, Illinois, currently residing in La Vista, Nebraska, and Kings North, Zessen. Accompanied by her husband, Scott Zessen, and was a member of the gymnastics team from 2001 through 2005. And Kings North Zessen. And now it is my honor to introduce the Chancellor of the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, Dr. Corey King.
Good evening and welcome. The mission of our great university includes the transformation of lives. Our recipients tonight meet that endeavor. They have, in so many ways, touched and transformed the lives of many in this room and beyond. This is one of my favorite spaces to be in. Tonight, we sit in the space where we honor and recognize and say thank you for the accomplishments of our recipients, and to say to them, we are grateful for allowing us to be a part of your journey. It is because of your talents, it is because of your spirit of innovation, and it is because of your pursuit of what is best that we are now more enriched as a community because of your lives and your journey. And so tonight, I ask you to do me one favor to all of our recipients. Sit back for just a moment and let us recognize you. Sit back for just a moment and let us honor you. And sit back for just a moment and let us applaud your accomplishments. Because we are certain that once that minute and moment is over, you will jump right back in and continue to serve and do what you do best. Go Warhawks.
Thank you, Dr. King. It is now my honor at this time. You can join me in welcoming Jim Stoppenbach, UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame board member, for a moment of reflection. Jim?
Please join me in a moment of prayer. Faithful and loving God, thank you for allowing us to come together this evening to honor our 2023 inductees to the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame. We celebrate the gifts and talents that you have bestowed upon each of them, and their willingness to share of themselves with others. Thank you for the support of their family and friends in this, a celebration of their accomplishments. May be with each of us in all we say and do. Help us all to discover our own personal gifts and talents. May we also find ways to give of ourselves for the service of others and live our lives to better the world around us. Please remember those we have lost who cannot be with us tonight. Keep their loved ones in your heart. Lord, be with us now during this time of food and fellowship. May the food bless our bodies and your spirit bless our souls. And finally, let our travels be safe as we make our way back to our homes after this very special day. With joy and thanksgiving, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jim. We want to give a special thanks, a shout out to Aladdin, the UW-Whitewater Food Service, and all of the people here tonight who are serving and taking such good care of us. Thank you so much. Great job. It's my honor now to welcome the following guests, honored guests this evening. Former UW-Whitewater Chancellor, Dr. Richard Telfer, and his wife, Ronnie. And of course, UW-Whitewater Chancellor, Dr. Corey King. UW-Whitewater Director of Intercollegiate Athletics, Ryan Callahan, and his wife, Danielle. And UW-Whitewater Athletics Hall of Fame Chair of the Board of Directors, Gary Harms, and his wife, Judy. And now, I am pleased to welcome to the podium Gary Harms. He will describe the purpose of the Hall of Fame. Gary.
Well, first of all, on behalf of Warhawk Athletics, I'd like to welcome you all back again to the 2023 Athletic Hall of Fame Banquet. We're so pleased to have you all with us tonight. Hope your day's gone great so far, and we're really anxious to induct this year's class of 2023, an outstanding class of inductees. At this time, I'd like to ask the Hall of Fame Board of Directors in attendance tonight to please stand and be recognized for your hard work and service and dedication throughout the year. So if the Board of Directors could please stand for a second. Thank you. Tonight we'll provide many opportunities to celebrate the significant accomplishments of several UW-Whitewater greats. These individuals are here because they did special things while they were on our campus. The Athletic Hall of Fame was established in 1965 through the efforts of the Alumni W Club and several representatives of the university faculty. The purpose of the Hall of Fame is to give lasting recognition to the following: student athletes who excelled in their chosen sports while attending UW-Whitewater and have made significant contributions in their professions and their communities. Individuals from the athletic department who have performed successfully and with distinction while working in the intercollegiate athletic department at UW-Whitewater. And finally, recognition by means of a distinguished service award to any person or persons, whether a coach, athletic director, community member, faculty member, booster, student, or contributor, who has significantly enhanced the success and well-being of our athletic programs. We also believe it is our purpose to help promote the interest in our university and our athletic department. And finally, the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame strives to display to the current students enrolled at UW-Whitewater and our student athletes and this institution of our extraordinary performances of the past, that have fueled and shaped the future and culture of our very exciting future. Thank you.
Thank you, Gary. And now it's my pleasure to bring forward Ryan Callahan. Please come on up to induct the Distinguished Service Award recipient.
Will Tim Patterson please come to the podium for induction? Tim has been connected to Warhawk Athletics for over 40 years, beginning as an athlete, through service on boards, committees, and clubs, and as a donor. Tim was a member of the football team from 1979 to 1982, and the baseball team from 1980 to 1983, before graduating in 1985 with a degree in general business with an emphasis in marketing. A former student assistant football coach as well, Tim was inducted into the Athletic Hall of Fame as an athlete in 2001. He served as the president of the W Club for 24 years, raising more than $250,000 for Warhawk Athletics during that time. He was a member of the Hall of Fame Committee for 25 years, serving as the chair for 3 years. A longtime member of the Quarterback Club, Tim is actively involved in golf outings, is a regular donor to Wally and Rod's raffle auction, and is a longtime advertising sponsor at Pruka Field at James B. Miller Stadium. Please help me congratulate Distinguished Service Award recipient, Tim Patterson.
First of all, thank you, Ryan. That was a very gracious introduction. First of all, I'd like to take this time to congratulate Bob Lanza and the rest of the amazing athletes here who are about to be inducted into this year's Hall of Fame. It's truly an honor to share this day with you. Thank you to Gary Harms and the Hall of Fame Committee for all the hard work and effort you put in to make this an incredible day for all the inductees. Also, thank you for selecting me as this year's Distinguished Service Award recipient. I'm extremely honored and grateful. Obviously, Whitewater has a special place in my heart. Not only did I get a great education here, but I also had the opportunity to both play football and baseball for the Warhawks. It's where I met my beautiful wife, Leah, and we were blessed to be able to have watch both of our sons play football here. So how did I get involved after I graduated? Well, I believe I was tricked, swindled, possibly even hoodwinked. Let me give you an example, or let me explain. About 30 years ago, my father-in-law, Jim Ganung, was the president of the UW-Whitewater National W Club. Jim, along with one of his best friends and partner in the hoodwinking, Bob Rezowitz, asked me to join as a new committee member of the W Club. Obviously, not wanting to disappoint my father-in-law, I said yes. Fast forward 1 year, and it was time to elect a new slate of officers. And out of the blue, Jim Ganung nominates me as the new president. Burzy quickly seconds the motion, and the next thing you know, I'm somehow running the show. Oh, it gets better. This was supposed to be a one-year term. Before I could even process the fact that I was now the National W Club president, Jim makes another motion. He says, oh, I'm sorry. Oh, to have the president serve a three-year term versus a one-year term. Brezzi again seconds. The wheels are now in motion for their next move, or what I believe was their original plan. During the course of the next 3 years, Jim, Brezzi, two of their other buddies, Don Zickert and Jerry Schmitz, all magically retired from the W Club. And I'm like, what the heck just happened? So that left me and my dear friend Joyce Follis to run things. So for the next 20 years or so, we did just that. I know Joyce isn't here tonight, but I really wanted to thank her for her support and sticking with me all those years. I truly appreciate it. During this time, I had the privilege to work with 7 different chancellors, 7 different athletic directors, and I believe I even probably had a full head of hair when I started that journey. Now, being the president of the W Club also gave me the position on the Hall of Fame board. So as long as I didn't vote myself out, I was going to be an active member of both committees. In the end, what started as a potential hoodwinking grew into a passion. There's so much reward and personal satisfaction that comes with volunteering your time to help and serve others. And to be recognized for that here today, I'm extremely blessed and grateful. Thank you.
We will now individually induct the Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame Class of 2023. Will Bob Lanza please come to the podium? Bob served the University of Wisconsin Whitewater Athletic Department in a variety of roles over his 32-year tenure. It spanned from 1985 to 2017, playing a vital role in the success of Warhawk Athletics. Bob was the department's business manager from 1985 to 2005, responsible for budgets, purchasing, travel, and game administration. He served as the interim athletic director during the spring semester in 2004 and was promoted to associate athletic director in 2006. Bob served on and chaired numerous university committees during his tenure, and he earned the UWW Academic Staff Excellence for Non-Instructional Staff Award in 2014. It recognizes outstanding performance. He also earned the 30-year service award in 2015. Bob continues to support the athletic programs through his work with summer camps administration, while also assisting with event management and with the athletic communication staff. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome 2023 Warhawk inductee, Bob Lanza.
All Okay. I lied to my family. I told I had it all in my head, and I didn't. I had to write it down. So here we go. First, I'd like to congratulate my fellow Hall of Fame inductees. I'm honored to be in the class of 2023 with you. You probably don't remember me as I was mostly behind the scenes, but I remember you, except for Andre, who was here before my time. It's hard to believe it's been 15 years for some of you to be out already. Congrats to Andre also. Many times through my years, I'd be in discussion with people on who the best Warhawk basketball player was, and I would name several who I thought were the best. And anybody that was here before me, when I started in 1985, would say, did you ever see Andre McCoy? I'd say, no, I never saw him. They said, well, he was the best. So Andre, I'm happy for you too to finally come in tonight. Congratulations. Of course, I want to thank the Hall of Fame. Go ahead. I want to, of course, thank the Hall of Fame committee. I had the honor of serving on that committee during my time here, occasionally, depending on what my position was. And I know how much hard work that is, and I know how much time he put into it. And it truly is a labor of love. And I believe this is one of the best Hall of Fame programs in the country. I really do. I want to thank all the coaches, the staff, the administrators, and the students I had the pleasure to work with. I also want to include the people in financial services, the travel office, purchasing, camps, and the facilities. Maintaining a great relationship with these offices across campus was essential to me being able to get things done in athletics. Winning with good people made for a very enjoyable and rewarding career. So here I am. I never scored a touchdown. I never hit a home run. I never ran the fastest lap. And I wasn't always the smartest person in the room. I'll admit to that. But I'm going into an athletic Hall of Fame. That's because I believe for 32 years, 8 athletic directors, including myself, 7 chancellors, I was always in the room. I was at every event. I always tried to see that Warhawk Athletics was viewed in a positive light. I've always thought that there was no department on campus that can generate as much positive recognition and awareness of the university as athletics does. And by this honor tonight, I think I did a pretty good job of that. In athletics, no success happens alone. It takes a team. In addition to the people I mentioned being before, the most important members of my team is my family. My daughters Amy, Courtney, and Megan are here, as well as Amy's husband, Martin. And I need to add this, because I wrote it before you surprised me. My sister Sue flew in from Oregon and surprised me. So Sue, thank you so much. My daughters grew up on this campus. I dragged them to as many events as I could. During holiday breaks, when there are no student workers around, I brought them in to sell tickets, flash the scores at gymnastics meets, or whatever needed to be done. So I put them to work. And they all participated in the summer camp programs here, including basketball, volleyball, gymnastics, and dance. And I dare say they've been to more Warhawk athletic events than anyone in this room. And I'm not kidding when I say that. They were always here. Thank you, girls. I'm so proud of each of you. And finally, and I remember this as clear as if it just happened yesterday, I'm sitting in my office, and our friend, the late, great Jim Miller, says to me, Bob, you cannot succeed in this profession unless you have an understanding spouse at home. I said, Mills, that's the truest thing you've ever said. For me, of course, that's my wife, Linda. This is not a 9-to-5, Monday through Friday profession. It is every weekend from Labor Day to Memorial Day. It's evenings, it's working over holiday breaks, it's travel, it's missed time at home. It's meals heated up in the microwave at 9:30 at night. The reason I was able to put in the time, the effort, and the energy for Warhawk Athletics was because of her love and support. I thank you more than anybody for making this possible. I think it is important that you all know that, especially you, Amy, Courtney, and Megan. This nice plaque has my name on it, but as much yours as it is mine. Thank you for all you've done. Congratulations to my Hall of Fame fellow inductees in the committee. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Go Warhawks. Congratulations. Thank you.
Great job, Bob. Will Brent Allen please come to the podium? Brent was an offensive lineman for three Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference championship teams, two national runners-up, and a member of the team that claimed the program's first national title during his four-year career with UW-Whitewater football from 2003 to 2007. As a senior in 2007, he led the Warhawks to its first ever national title for football as the Remington Award winner, as the nation's top center in Division III. That season, Brent bolstered a line that helped running back Justin Beaver set the Division III record for rushing yards in a season, 2,455. A second-team All-American selection by D3Football.com in 2007, Brent was a first-team All-Region pick in 2007 and two-time first-team All-WIAC selection during his career. The Mequonago native was selected to the WIAC All-Time Team, which was created in 2012 as part of the league's centennial celebration. Also, a two-time member of the WIAC Scholastic Honor Roll, Brent graduated in 2007 with a bachelor's degree in human resource management. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Brent Allen.
All right, here. Oh, this is the speech head. We won today. I want to congratulate the other 2023 inductees. Really special class that I get the opportunity to go into with. And I want to get the thanks in as well. My father, Mark Allen, who could not be here today. My mother, Linda Allen. They together came to every single football game that they could. I think they missed one or two because my little brother Chad was playing the state playoff, so thank them very much. My wife Tiffany, who's here, she's the rock of our family and takes care of most everything, especially during football season. My children Marcus and Major, I already mentioned my brother Chad. My coaches from high school, Keith Hensler and Lee Purdy. Coaches from Whitewater, Bob Brezowitz, Stan Zweifel, Steve Dinkel, Lance Leopold, and Lee Munger, and then my teammates, really all of them. Hard to look bad when Justin Beaver's your running back, and Bray Ramsey and Dan Anstead are your guards that you're double teaming with. And then Ryan Kleppe as well. I got to go against him for my entire career, and he was considerably better than me, and he made me better as a defensive lineman, and I, to this day, still talk about how having great competition in practice will make you a better football player, and I owe a lot to Ryan Kleppe. Thanks to UW-Whitewater and specifically the athletic department for creating an environment that was special and that student-athletes could achieve success at. I was blessed to have three outstanding offensive line coaches. Coach Purdy, who was my high school offensive line coach, taught me technique and importance of understanding the scheme. He's a very cerebral coach, and I am very fortunate to have played for him learning that way. Coach Dinkle, who's here today, let's give him a round of applause. He's the man. At the time I got to work with him, Coach Dinkle was a zone offense guru, both schematically and technically. I had a tendency to be a bit rabid as a football player, and he was definitely the man who was controlling the leash. How loose or how tight my chain was up to him. Sometimes he'd walk me over the edge, and sometimes he'd bring me back. But in all honesty, I don't think anyone else in the country could have gotten as much out of me as Coach Dinkle did, and I think mainly because he supported me and believed that I would be able to eventually get it done. And again, this is two claps for Coach Dinkle, but if we can get him one more time, I would appreciate it. He's the man. And finally, my father, first and always, he was my biggest fan and forever coach. Taught me about mentality, physicality, and toughness. Talk about like positive mental attitude. He was teaching me that, even though he didn't have the words to say that that's what he was teaching me. Essentially, if there's a negative thought that creeps into your head, you're going to put that out there. And I appreciate him so much. I remember when I went and asked him if I could play tackle football in the seventh grade, and he was a college football player. He said, we can. He never pushed me towards it. He said, we can, but if we're going to do it, we're going to do it the right way. And that meant bear crawls, stadium stairs, jumping rope, push-ups, and sit-ups, which as a seventh grader I wasn't super excited about, but he kind of taught me the way on it, and I really appreciated him for that. He would have been really happy to be here. You wouldn't have missed him. He probably would have met you all and said, hey, that's my son. Miss him dearly. I was listed at 6 foot my senior year, so I want to thank Coach Munger for that, because that's not true. But I'm pretty confident that I'm the last 5'9 and 3/4 inch offensive lineman to go into the Hall of Fame at UW-Whitewater. Actually, is Coach Rindle still here? I'm going to call him and tell him to get back to recruiting the 5'9 kids, because that'll help us out in the future. Actually, thanks again for this opportunity. I'm truly grateful. This is a lifetime goal of mine, and now I have an opportunity to set a new goal. That's what you do. You achieve a goal, you set a new one, and hopefully someday I get to sit here and be a part of this as either a coach or, if I'm lucky enough, a father. Thank you, and swing the axe. I'm kidding. Pound the rock.
Ask your indulgence for just a moment. 2009, and I say this, all of you that are head coaches out here or were head coaches at one time, you know exactly what I'm talking about. When you take a position, you know you're only as good as the people that you surround yourself with. You want to surround yourself with people who are passionate, who are knowledgeable, who love the sport, and are going to be willing to work with kids and be a teacher. Well, in 2009, I was smart enough to hire our next inductee to be on our staff at Whitewater High School. Well, Dan Heitman, please come to the podium.
Thank you.
Dan is one of the most decorated throwers in men's track and field program history. Competing from 2005 to 2008, Dan is a two-time national champion in the discus, securing back-to-back crowns in 2007 and 2008, and at one time holding the national record. A six-time All-American, he finished among the top eight in the outdoor national championships all 4 years of his career in the discus. His junior campaign featured a fifth-place finish in the shot put indoors, followed by the bronze in the outdoor championships, in addition to his national title in the discus. Dan went on to compete in the United States Olympic Trials in the discus in 2012, advancing to the finals in that event. He holds the program record in the discus with a distance of 59.87 meters, 196 feet, 5 inches, recorded in 2008. It ranks him fourth now all time in NCAA Division III history. And on top of that, I can attest to you, he is a great coach. The South Milwaukee native graduated in 2009 with a bachelor's degree in physical education. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Dan Heitinen.
So first off, I want to thank the Hall of Fame Inductee Committee and Gary Harms. This was an awesome event. And also, it's an honor to share the stage with the rest of the inductees tonight. So thank you for a fantastic day. Got to talk to a lot of people, catch up. and, you know, it's a true honor that I'm able to represent this university that's given me so much, both academically and athletically. I worked with the best people that you could possibly imagine. And I will never forget the memories that I had at this university. And the other thing is, honestly, it's hard to believe I'm standing here today. 21 years ago, I was laying flat on my back on my gym's hardwood floor due to a botched high jump attempt. I originally had joined track and field because I was looking to improve my vertical jump for basketball my senior year. And my days of wanting to be LeBron James obviously were short-lived. I turned into a thrower somehow. And while I was laying there, gasping for breath, half unconscious, my head coach, Mark Hoffman back there, came over to me and he said, "Yeah, maybe you should give throwing a shot." And I looked at him like he was crazy, like he was the one who had just bounced off the floor and knocked a few screws loose. I was 175 pounds, soaking wet. And the reason I bring this up is that you don't have to be the biggest, fastest, or strongest athlete out there to find success. The most important thing that I learned was the value of finding amazing people and motivating people around you to push you every day. And so that's where I'd like to make my dedication tonight to some of these folks here tonight. My high school coach, Mark Hoffman, and Greg Dufek, for pushing me out of my comfort zone and giving me the confidence when I didn't have any. My Whitewater teammates who were there to help me, you know, do extra practice at the end of the day when it was cold, wet, rainy, whatever. They were out there helping me get those extra repetitions in. My throws coach, Dave Hahn, who sat and same thing was with me on film, going through extra technique, after hours, all the time. My incredible mentor, Mark Moss, who acted as a father figure to me because I did not have a father, and he was at my side for so many years, and the memories with him are just once in a lifetime, so I thank him for pushing me through the hard times in college. And my mom and sister who are here tonight, They were at my side the whole time when going through a lot of obstacles as well in college. And there was a lot of times post-collegiately when I was, you know, trying to compete for the Olympic team where I just wanted to throw in the towel, and they were at my side the entire time. And lastly, my beautiful wife who traveled here with me 1,000 miles to be celebrated tonight, and you know, continuing to make me the better man each and every day. So thank you guys. Congratulations to the inductees tonight.
Rebecca Nelson Johnson, please come to the podium. Rebecca was a right side hitter for 3 Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference championships and 4 NCAA tournament qualifying teams, including national semifinalist in 2006, national runner-up in 2007, and a national championship in 2005. She was named to the NCAA Division III Championship All-Tournament Team as a sophomore in 2005. A third-team All-American selection by the American Volleyball Coaches Association as a junior, Rebecca helped UW-Whitewater claim WIAC tournament titles in 2006 and 2007. She holds top 20 marks in the program's career record book in attack attempts, 3,122. In matches with 20 or more kills, that would be 3. In kills, 1,158. In matches with the double figure kills, 53. With digs, 1,249. Matches with double figures, 53. A hitting percentage of 276 and 133 service aces. The 2-time All WIAC pick was also the league's Judy Kruckman Scholar Athlete Award winner in 2007. A 4-time member of the WIAC Scholastic Honor Roll, the Williams Bay native graduated in 2008 with a bachelor's degree in physical education. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Rebecca Nelson Johnson.
Proud of you, kid. Very proud of you.
After hearing that stat of how many times I swung my arm, I know why my shoulder hurts, and can thank Kate for setting a lot of those balls up to me. I want to start by thanking the Hall of Fame Committee, Gary Harms, the Athletic Department. This day has been truly incredible. I spend a lot of time still on campus, but this day is extra special to me. It's such an honor to be recognized with this group of athletes and inductees, and it's fun to go in with a teammate, too. So congratulations to all of you. Being inducted into the Hall of Fame has prompted a lot of reflection for me, and it's led me through a great exercise in practicing gratitude. I'd like to start by thanking my parents, Bruce and Carolyn Nelson. Thank you for signing me up for every sport that was available, for traveling to every game, and being the most supportive and generous people that I know. Being an athlete became a strong part of my identity very early on, and I have you to thank for this. And I should also thank my two big brothers up front here. They were always really hard on me, and I attribute a lot of my toughness to you two. But truly, they drove, flew, streamed every game that they could in my volleyball career. And thank you for being here today and supporting your little sister. And to my two nieces who are able to join here today, I'm so proud that you're now a student here at Whitewater and passing on that torch. When I think back to the memories of playing volleyball at UW-Whitewater, it's less about the volleyball, and it's more about the relationships. I remember sharing earbuds on the bus rides. We had iPods back then, not phones. The hours in the training room under heat, ice, stim, making jokes with Steve and Amy, stopping by Coach Vanessa's office after every class, and I was a PE major, so spent a lot of time in that building. And thank goodness that that Hall of Famer, 2022 Hall of Famer, C. Polk, didn't get cut her freshman year because she ended up becoming one of my best friends. But there's a pretty serious chapter of my UW-Whitewater volleyball experience that has shaped my life. Jamie Conrath was a teammate of mine and the reason why I rode the pine a lot of my freshman year. She was an incredible right side. But that winter, Jamie was in a car accident and suffered a traumatic brain injury. I remember sitting at the hospital with my teammates for an entire day while she was in a coma. I remember hearing the news she may never walk again. But for those of you who don't know, Jamie did walk again, and that's all because of how determined and incredible she is. And we're still lucky to gather together. She's the absolute best at reminiscing with us about those good old days of Whitewater volleyball. I don't think our team could have bounced back from Jamie's accident without the leadership of Chris Russell. Chris knew we were broken and found a way to unite us to play for Jamie. We carried her jersey to every match. When we faced our challenges, we looked to Jamie for strength. And we held her jersey high when we posed for that championship picture. Years down the road, I remember chatting with Chris Russell about life, as you do with your favorite mentor. And she shared a powerful message that has stuck with me until today. She said, "It's not about winning championships, but what I love most about coaching is seeing you all leave this program as strong, confident women." She wasn't teaching us about winning and losing. Through volleyball, she was teaching us about life. How to be grounded in our values, how to be determined and relentless in achieving our goals, how to see no obstacle as insurmountable. The lessons learned under her leadership are always with me, especially now that I'm in a role where I mentor young people. And Chris, I thank you for continuing to be supportive of me and my mentor to this day. You always hold space for each of us, and I'm so lucky to have played on the last team that you coached. Although I do still play Thursday night volleyball in Women's Sixes League with fellow Warhawk Julie Goss, and we occasionally bring out that ultra-competitive side and slam some balls, we've been known to win a couple for Parks and Rec t-shirts. It's really the personal development and the lifelong friendships that I made during my time at UW-Whitewater that mean the most to me. So to all of my college and high school teammates that are here today, thank you for coming and for the best memories. I also have to thank UW-Whitewater Athletics for the opportunity to meet my husband, Mike. What a matchmaker you can be. At the time, Mike was just some track guy, and now he's the most important person in my life. Mike, I can't thank you enough for being the rock that grounds me, the wind in my sail, and the love of my life. And although our children aren't here today, I want to thank you for being exactly who you are and giving my life such purpose and joy in being your mother. I hope that you find something that changes you for the better, as being a Warhawk did for me. Thank you.
Will Jessica Coleman please come to the podium? Jessica was a national champion for the women's track and field program during her four-year career from 1998 to 2001. A two-time Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference champion in the weight throw, 2001 indoors, and the hammer throw, 2001 outdoors, Jessica finished among the top eight nationally on three separate occasions. She earned her first All-American honor by finishing fourth in the discus in 2000 before winning the national title in the weight throw in 2001. She capped that season with her third All-American honor by finishing eighth in the hammer throw at the National Outdoor Championships in 2001. The New Holstein native previously held the program record in the hammer throw with a mark of 54 meters 80. That's 179 feet 9 inches, recorded in 2001. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Jessica Coleman.
First of all, I'd like to thank UW-Whitewater and the athletic program for inducting me. It's a great honor. I didn't start my collegiate career here at UW-Whitewater. I actually started at Marquette University. But it took me about a semester to figure out that that wasn't really where I belonged. So I transferred here after that first semester. And I found the place I belonged. Whitewater felt like home to me. I've made so many friends while I was here and have had the honor of participating in this wonderful athletic program. Along with making friends, lifelong friends, one of whom is here tonight and has also been inducted into the Hall of Fame here at Whitewater, I've had so many wonderful experiences, first-time experiences here, coaches who supported me, Coach Bukowski, who coached me my first year here, I'll never forget. We don't do shot put, discus. We do those in high school, but not, we don't do the hammer, the weight throw, in high school. We do them at the college level. I'll never forget when Coach Bukowski said to me, Jessica, you're going to love this. And I looked at him and I said, no, I hate this. It was terrible. But what do you know? I practiced, he supported me, and it did turn out to be something that I really loved. So I also want to let everybody know what an honor it is to be inducted into the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame. I never imagined that I'd be here. I want to thank the people that helped me to get here, including my parents, Ken and Julie Coleman, my siblings who are here tonight, my godparents, my son Cohen and Ethan. I grew into the person that I am today because of the time that I had here and the experiences that I had here. And I really loved my time here, and I'm so proud to have been a Warhawk. So thank everybody for their encouragement, their support and love throughout that time. It has made me into the person I am, and I couldn't have gotten here without that. So thank you, everybody.
Will Kate Lazat Langfeld please come to the podium? Kate was a setter for three Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference championship teams and was a four-time NCAA Division III tournament qualifier, including the national semifinalist finish in 2006, national runner-up in 2007, and of course, the national title in 2005. The two-time All-WIAC selection was also a first-team All-Region honoree in 2007 before claiming second-team All-American honors that same season from the American Volleyball Coaches Association. She was named to the NCAA Division III Championship All-Tournament Team in 2007. Kate recorded 71 assists in a single match in 2007, a mark that ranks among the top 12 in WIAC history. She holds top 15 marks in UW-Whitewater's program record book in career assists with 3,315. In matches with double-figure digs, 53, and assists in a season, 1,566 and 1,528. A four-time member on the WIAC Scholastic Honor Roll, the Stoughton native graduated in 2008 with a bachelor's degree in biology. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Kate Lazat Langfeld.
Congratulations. Well, first I'd like to thank the Hall of Fame board for choosing me to receive this award. I'm very grateful and honored to be standing up here tonight along with all these other outstanding athletes and other inductees. So thank you very much, and thank you, Gary, for all the hard work you put in today. The sport of volleyball has had a profound impact on my life. It's taught me lessons in perseverance and commitment. It's led to many long-standing friendships. It's given me a career that allows me to help other young players work towards achieving their goals. And without volleyball, I would never have met my husband, Chuck, 12 years ago. The two most important people I have to thank for introducing me to the sport of volleyball are my mom and dad, Rhonda and Bruce. As a child, they would take me to their rec volleyball leagues, pass the ball back and forth with me in between games, and sometimes even let me jump in and play. They made it possible for me to play club volleyball throughout my middle school and high school years, which, for those of you that don't know, it's quite the expensive and time-consuming sport. My dad also volunteered as the assistant varsity coach during my time in high school. As a teenager, you can imagine I wasn't always thrilled that he was always around and always trying to tell me what to do. But looking back, I'm very grateful that he took on that role and that he was present and involved in so much of my volleyball career. So thank you, Mom and Dad, for the support and all the sacrifices you made for me as I was growing up. And thank you for introducing me to this sport that has offered me so many successes. Besides my dad, I've had a number of other coaches that have pushed me, encouraged me, and challenged me throughout my volleyball career. And to each and every one of those, I'm very grateful that you've been a part of it. I specifically want to thank Coach Russell, if she's still here in the back there. Thank you, Coach, for recruiting me. Prior to Coach showing interest in me as an athlete, Whitewater was not exactly top on my list of schools I was hoping to attend. But she helped show me that Whitewater could be a good fit for me, and she was right, and for that I'm very grateful. Attending Whitewater has been one of the best life decisions I've made, both athletically and academically. So thank you, Coach. I appreciate all that you've done for me. I also want to thank Coach Boudreau, who I don't believe is here tonight, but she did help lead us to the 2005 National Championship and to two very successful seasons after that. Those years have become some of the most memorable of my life and are moments that I will never forget. Also, thank you to all my teammates, and congrats to Becca. I'm so glad to be going into the Hall of Fame with you as well. You guys are the reason that our team achieved such great success and the reason that both me and Becca are able to stand up here tonight and be honored with this award. So thank you guys. Last but not least, thanks to my husband Chuck, my brother Kyle and his wife who are here tonight, and all my other friends and family that came out to support me. It means a lot to me that you guys are here. Thank you.
Andre McCoy, please come to the podium. Andre was a member of the 1984 National Championship basketball team, the first for UW-Whitewater's men's basketball, and the first men's basketball title for any institution in the Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference. A prolific scorer, Andre is the program's all-time leading scorer with 2,000 points, accumulated during his four-year career from 1981 to 1984. That mark remains among the top 10 in WIAC history for career scoring. He also owns program career marks in the field goals made, 793. Field goal attempts, 1,566, while ranking second in free throws made, 416, free throws attempted, 547. During the national championship campaign in 1983-84, he compiled 697 points, second in the program record book for scoring in a single season. He went on to earn second-team All-American honors from the National Association of Basketball Coaches, and he was selected as the WIAC Player of the Year that season. A three-time first-team All-WIAC pick, Andre compiled a team record of 87-27 while leading the Warhawks to a pair of Final Four appearances in his four seasons. The Madison native was inducted into the WIAC Hall of Fame in 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Andre McCoy.
Well, I don't have a piece of paper to take out and say a script, but I want to thank the committee. for selecting me into this year Hall of Fame. I would like to slate my mother, who's not here. She's a little ill, but she was my rock. She was my cheerleader. She was the one behind the bench always yelling, you know, for us. I would like to thank my family, my daughter and grandson that's here, my common wife, common law wife, Andrea. I would like to thank Coach Vandermeer. Okay, Coach Vandermeer. That's a long story right there, right? And I only got a little bit, 3 minutes. But Coach molded me into being a young man. You know, when I first came to Whitewater, I was headstrong. You know, I wasn't ready for the university. You know, I was still a kid. But Coach helped me become a young man. You know what I mean? And I want to thank you, Coach. I want to thank Coach Weaver. He was a part of that also. He was the one behind Coach, you know what I mean? So, like, if Coach yelled at me on the court or something, and I go back over to the corner and I start calling coaches all kinds of names, right? Coach Weaver would be the one to come up to me and say, settle down, everything's going to be all right, you know what I mean? So I want to thank them very much because they were the ones that made my career very dominant that it was. Bob, thank you, you know what I mean? I didn't think I was the greatest, but I was a good player. You know, I just came and did my thing. You know what I mean? And I just wanted, my speech is very short because, you know, this is something nervous to me. But I want to thank all y'all for selecting me to be in this Hall of Fame. Thank you very much. And thank all of y'all for coming. Thank you.
Derek Stanley, please come to the podium. Derek was a two-sport standout for UW-Whitewater as a member of the Warhawk football team from 2003 to 2006, competing for the men's track and field program from 2004 to 2008, a two-time All-Region selection and three-time All-Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference wide receiver. He was a member of two WIAC championship teams and two national runners-up in 2005 and 2006. By the end of his career, he held top five marks in the conference record book in receiving touchdowns in a career, 35, receiving touchdowns in a game, 4, the longest kickoff return, 97 yards, in receiving yards in a season, 1,328, and receiving touchdowns in a season, 16. In the UW-Whitewater record book, he held numerous records for season and career receiving yards, touchdowns, and kickoff returns. Selected to the WIAC's all-time football team as a part of the league's centennial celebration, Derek was a seventh-round pick of the St. Louis Rams in 2007. Derek was also one of the most decorated track and field athletes in program history. A five-time All-American. He was the national runner-up at the 2004 indoor championships. He finished eighth in 2006 and sixth in 2008 indoors. Outdoors, Derek claimed bronze at the 2006 national meet and was sixth in 2004. He was a three-time WIAC champion in the jump, winning the title indoors in 2004 and sweeping the conference meets in 2006. His leap of 7.5 meters, 24 feet, 7 1/4 inches in 2004 remains the program record in the long jump. The Verona native graduated in 2018 with a bachelor's degree in physical education. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Derek Stanley.
Dennis would be proud.
Should have won that national championship in 2004. So I know we're to the end of this thing, so I'll keep it short and sweet. You know, me and Ann anchoring the deal here. But it's with great honor and humility that I stand here before you guys. First of all, congratulations to everyone else. It's amazing to be able to go in with a couple of my former teammates, Dan and Brent. Amazing being teammates with you guys. But it's a great honor to be able to be celebrated today with everyone else, Gary, you guys and the staff. It's an amazing achievement. It's recognition of mine. It's a testament of the amazing support that I've had from my family, my friends, coaches, the teammates, the entire Whitewater community. It's really been, you know, extremely instrumental in both my football and my track career. As you heard, that was pretty a long thing. It felt good listening to all that a little bit. I want to express my gratitude to the selection committee, like I said before. To be recognized amongst these legends and the icons here at Whitewater is truly humbling. It really is. You know, as I stand here today, filled with pride, not only for the personal achievements that I've been able to accomplish, but also just to be a part of the great family and tradition here at Whitewater. And just being here to allow me to really make my dreams come true. You know, that being able to be selected again to play in the National Football League. So thank you, Coach Brez, and everybody else for, you know, allowing me to facilitate that dream of mine. College years, they taught me how to be a great teammate, how to be committed to the community. Sorry, guys, I'm a little nervous, but let me just talk from the cuff. Thank you guys for this. This is amazing, right? I've had a great time. I've learned so much here at Whitewater. Again, to be a great teammate, the commitment. I've learned how to party here with these guys, you know, so I've been able to carry that. This is amazing. So I'm really thankful to everyone. I would be remiss if I didn't express my deepest appreciation to my family, my friends that are here. Everyone, I got some friends from St. Louis that came up to support me as well. My brother from California, my sister from Nashville, you know, my mom, she's in Houston. I got my dad and my stepmom and my little baby boy back there who was supposed to walk me down the aisle, but he was asleep going up the aisle. Thank you guys for your sacrifice, the countless hours that you guys have spent supporting me. I truly appreciate that. The hours, come and pick me up from practice back and forth. You know, you really guys have helped facilitate the determination that it takes to get me to where I've been able to be. So the seduction is just as much as you guys as it is mine. So I truly appreciate this honor. Thank you guys. I'm glad to be a part of this amazing tradition here at Whitewater. Together we've created some memories that'll last a lifetime. So go Warhawks. Thank you guys.
Ann Kingsnorth Zessen. Please come to the podium. Ann was a member of the UW-Whitewater gymnastics team from 2001 to 2004. A two-time national qualifier, she went on to tie for fourth in the all-around at the 2004 National Collegiate Gymnastics Association Championship, earning All-American honors. Zessen was an All-Wisconsin Intercollegiate Athletic Conference honoree in three events in 2003 and in the all-around in 2004. She was a member of a team that held multiple program records during the previous scoring era. Only four scores were used at that time, including six of the top 20 team scores on the floor exercise, including the program record, seven of the top 20 team scores on the uneven bars, including the program record, four of the top 20 scores on the balance beam, and the fourth highest team vault score. A three-year honoree on the WIAC's Scholastic Honor Roll, the Oak Lawn, Illinois native graduated in 2005 with a bachelor's degree in physical education. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 2023 Warhawk Hall of Fame inductee, Ann Kingsnorth Zessen.
Well, thank you so much to the Hall of Fame Board and Gary for just making this day and all these events possible, and a huge congratulations to all the other 2023 inductees. This will certainly be a memorable day for all of us, but it was those memories that brought us all here today. UW-Whitewater is a special place. It's where I was finally part of a team. It's where I found my husband and my faith. And I'll certainly never forget the years I spent here. I'm trying really hard not to cry. So we'll see if I make it to the end. I haven't yet. So as a little girl, I dreamed of the day I would compete at the collegiate level. I didn't just dream of the day. I worked hard for it, and it took a village to get me there. As the lone competitor for my high school team at H.L. Richards in Illinois, I didn't have a team to call my own. There were a lot of tears and bumps in the road, but I managed to make it there with many supportive people in my corner whom I'd like to thank today. First off, my parents, who spent countless hours in the gym and in the car, driving me to all my practices and never missed a competition even through my collegiate years and Wisconsin snow. My parents, still showing their support today, wouldn't have missed this day, as this day is just as much for them as it is for me. As a parent now, I realize all the sacrifices you made for me to fulfill my dream, and I could never repay you. Thanks, Mr. Davey, Hun, and Dad, for being here with me today. Hopefully, the bleacher butts were worth it. Thank you to my childhood coaches at Oak Lawn Park District. My coach, Deirdre Nizolik-White, is actually here today. Thank you for always being my biggest cheerleader and for picking me up all those times I landed on my butt on vault, which was a lot of times in high school. Without your years of coaching and dedication to helping me succeed, I wouldn't be here today. Thank you to Judy Redman from Gainers Gymnastics for helping me find my feet on vault, which I was able to compete through college. Thank you to my coaches at UW-Whitewater. Coach Wendy Munson, your positivity was just contagious, and you made competing in college gymnastics so much fun. I'll never forget all the time you took to listen to me, and you always made our team feel like such a family. Coach Ryan Bendixson, your knowledge and dedication to the sport of gymnastics is incredible, and I was never worried to try some crazy combination of skills if you were there to catch me. Matt Zolich and Jared Stevenson, you brought all the fun and energy to every competition, and there was never a dull moment when you guys were around. Coach Jen White, thanks for helping me as I struggled through injury, but was still able to finish my collegiate career competing and placing at the national level. Thanks for finishing the journey with me. Thank you to all my teammates from 2000 to 2004. Standing alongside of you every meet, pinkies wrapped through the national anthem will always be such a sweet memory. The dream of competing at the collegiate level was extra special because of all of you. Joy, Marisa, and Lisa, thanks for always standing in my corner cheering me on. I'm grateful for all your support and hugs. My husband, Scott. Scott and I met in Lee Hall in the fall of 2000. Dated through college, was married 5 years later. As an athlete himself, I saw how his faith fueled him on the basketball court and how humble he truly was. He showed me how faith in God would be how I could make it through the difficulties and that with Christ, all things are truly possible. My girls, Carly and Maya, this is the part, I can't get past it, sorry. I hope you see what a special place Whitewater is for your dad and me. I pray you could use the gifts God has given you to go out and pursue your passions. Do not be afraid to dream big and remember Colossians 3:23. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Thanks so much.
Chancellor King will now accept the plaques on behalf of the university. Chancellor King.
Thank you. On behalf of the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, I congratulate all inductees tonight and thank you for your significant contributions and successes of our athletic program. The Hall of Fame plaques are officially accepted, and we, as a university, will permanently display in the Athletic Hall of Fame on the walls of the Williams Center. We are grateful, and we thank you.
And now it's my pleasure to introduce Ryan Callahan, UW-Whitewater's Director of Intercollegiate Athletics. He will present the State of the Athletics Address. Ryan?
So before I start, I have a quick story. So Bob Lanza has been a mentor of mine for many, many years, and 4 years ago I took over as AD, and I think it was after I accepted a position, he comes in my office and he shuts the door and he says, "You really want this?" And I said, "Yeah, this is my dream. Like, once I got done playing, this is where I want to be. I want to be leading Warhawk Athletics." "Why?" He goes, "Well, I was interim in 2004. I'm like, "Yeah?" He goes, "Your baseball team got in a bench-clearing brawl against Oshkosh, and I had to talk to the police department." So on behalf of the 2004 Warhawk baseball team, I apologize for our actions, Bob. So first of all, I'd like to congratulate this year's inductees. Tonight is a special occasion, and all of you should be extremely proud of your accomplishments in and out of competition. Whitewater has a rich tradition of athletic excellence, and you all are some of the best. The 22-23 school year was extremely successful. 17 of our 22 sports qualified for national postseason competition. We claimed 7 WIAC team championships. 12 of our student athletes received WIAC Players of the Year, and 36 of our athletes received All-American status. Four Warhawks claimed individual national championships. Gymnast Kara Walsh won the vault title. Christian Patska won the indoor track and field 5,000 and outdoor steeplechase. Gracie Holland won the indoor pole vault. And Jarrett Schinholster won the 184-pound championship and was named most outstanding wrestler. I would also like to highlight one team in particular from last year. Men's basketball dealt with tragedy in July of 2022 with the passing, a sudden passing of Derek Gray. Derek was a captain and led the team in points, rebounds, and steals the previous year. Pat and his staff did a great job of navigating the situation and getting the team ready for the season. The team finished fourth in conference and had to win the conference tournament to get a bid to the NCAA tournament, which they did. Their postseason journey took them from La Crosse to Oshkosh to Cleveland to Ashland, Virginia, and finally to Fort Wayne in a matter of 20 days. They lost the Final Four, but their run is a testament to the power that athletics can have on a group of individuals. Overall, Warhawk Athletics finished number 11 in the Division III Learfield Cup. This was the highest finish by any WIAC team and was also the highest public school finish. Our fall sports are off to a great start, and we're optimistic about some national tournament appearances. Women's golf has already punched their ticket to the NCAA in May with their seventh consecutive WIAC championship. Women's volleyball is 23-4 and ranked number 6 in the country. The men's cross-country team, fourth in the nation, and finished second today at the WIAC championships. And if I'm not mistaken, Christian Patska won it today. Football is currently number 5 in the country and in second place in the WIAC. And finally, women's tennis complained their record-setting 17th consecutive WIAC team championship. I would also like to recognize the coaches that retired or left to pursue new opportunities. Ryan Kwame was the head women's soccer coach for 12 years. He has the most wins in program history with 155. His replacement, Dan Montani, is doing a great job. Dan, are you here right now? Can please stand up and Kevin Bullis was the head football coach and retired after 7 seasons as head coach and 15 total seasons with the Warhawk football. Kevin's teams had 6 playoff appearances, highlighted by a national runner-up in 2019. Jace Reynolds took over and is doing a great job so far. I don't think Jace is here. I know he's got a few kids at home, so he's gone, right? All right. You have to come to the November 11th game to congratulate him. Pat Miller retired after 22 years as head men's basketball coach. He took the team to 3 Final Fours and 2 national championships. His contributions to UW-Whitewater will be felt for years to come. His longtime assistant, Jared Wixer, has taken over as interim head coach. Jared, are you here? Stand up. Went to the Final Four last year, 2 in the preseason. No pressure, bud. So now the best part of the evening is not the banquet or the awards, is being with all of you who embody the Warhawk spirit more than anyone. Everyone in this room has been vital in continuing to build and support the strong foundation that was laid over 150 years ago. I'm confident through our current leadership, continued support from people like all of you, the best is yet to come for our great university and Warhawk Athletics. Thank you to everyone in attendance, and congratulations to all of the inductees. Go Hawks.
Thank you, Ryan. And now once again, let's welcome Gary Harms, the chair of the Hall of Fame Board of Directors. He will read the Hall of Fame roll call.
At this time, could we please have a moment of silence for the deceased members of the Hall of Fame, which included 4 individuals who have passed away since we last were together, last Hall of Fame. Raleigh Cooper, William Fardy, Rod Sonnenberg, and Bruce York. Please have a moment of silence for these individuals. Thank you. I will now read the Hall of Fame roll call. The individual members of the Hall of Fame, followed by the Distinguished Service Award members that are present, please stand and remain standing when your name is called. Please hold your applause until all the names have been announced. At the completion of the roll call, if there's anybody present whose name was not called, please stand up so you might be recognized. Brent Allen. Bob Brezowitz. Ryan Callahan. Tabitha Fendrick. Mike Garecki. Andra Gremmer. Dan Heitenen. Rebecca Nelson Johnson. Jessica Coleman. Lori Copine. Jody Landish. Kate Lizotte Langfeld. Bob Lanza. Andre McCoy. Corinne Montani. Rich Murphy. Nancy Nelson. Tim Patterson. Chris Russell. Derek Stanley. Jim Stoppenbach. Dave Augie Vandermeulen. Brenda Volk. Lamont Weaver. Matt Young. Ann Kingsnorth Zessen. Members of the 1983-84 men's basketball team. Joel Tomsky, Pete Miller, Andre McCoy. Members of the 1985 women's golf team, Mary Ross. And our Distinguished Service Award winners that are present this evening. Nancy Cooper. Tom Fick. Dick Haven. Tim Patterson. Richard Telfer. Ronnie Telfer. Do we miss anybody present? Okay, let's have a big round of applause for our Hall of Fame members. Thank you. You may be seated. To honor the history of the Hall of Fame, I'd like to quote the exact words from our good friend, coach, and colleague, Jim Miller, who many of you know. He was a longtime chair of the Hall of Fame committee. Jim so passionately stated, "And so the tradition goes on, a tradition that celebrates all that is right in sport, talent, pride, courage, and the ability to endure. And next year again, the call will go out across the campus. Young athletes will enter the arena in the fields, make the attempt, and compete as a Warhawk. And when it is over, there will again be but the few, the honored members of the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame, a symbol of excellence." It's the goal of the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame to make each of you feel that you are the most important person on this campus today. From the time you arrived at the parade this morning until right now, we wanted each of you to feel that you're number one. We want your kids, your parents, your friends to question, were you really that good? When you leave tonight, I hope you can feel in your heart that we achieve this goal and our motto, the UW-Whitewater Athletic Hall of Fame, we do it better than everyone else. At this time, I want to give special thanks to the following people who made tonight's banquet possible. First of all, our outstanding MC, Mark Moss, former high school track coach at Whitewater High School, an unbelievable person. Thank you, Mark. Our new Chancellor, Corey King, who's now also a proud member of the Hall of Fame board. Thank you, Chancellor King. Our athletic director, Ryan Callahan, who's leading us to some great places. Our PowerPoint presentation that you saw tonight, put on by Joe Corallo. Joe's upstairs in the booth. Joe also serves as our assistant women's basketball coach, who made a great run themselves last year to the Final Four. The University Center staff, the tech crew, and the catering staff. To Tapp and Shaw, our photographer, wherever Taps is. Thank you, Taps. To Joe Mabee and UW-Whitewater TV and their videography that is being done during this whole ceremony that the Hall of Famers will receive after the banquet a couple months from now. So thank you, Joe, and your staff. Angela Kelm, our sports information director, who could not be here this evening with other Warhawk athletic events going on. Hannah Scorsone and Marianne Wolk with continuing education services, who you all registered through, so thank you for their services. And finally, again, thank you to the Athletic Hall of Fame Board of Directors for all your work throughout the year. As we conclude tonight's banquet, I'd like to ask everyone to please remove your name tags at this time. You can place them on your tables and we'll pick those up. If you could just leave those there, we'd appreciate it. I also like to ask that all 2023 inductees please get your plaques with you, all 10 of you, and meet in the front of the stage in front of the 2023 banner for Taps to take more pictures of you of tonight's events. Thank you again for your attendance tonight. Congratulations again to our outstanding class of 2023. Safe travels to everyone. Good night and have a great evening. Thank you.